Hello, Cloud Gurus. I'm Nigel Poulton, the author of the Kubernetes book, and this is Kubernetes This Month, the show that brings you all the news and other good stuff going on in the world of Kubernetes. First on the agenda are my five top Kubernetes news items from the past month. So, the OCI announced version 1.0 of the Container Distribution Spec. So the OCI is a standards body that already brought us the Container Runtime Spec and the Container Image Spec, both of which have been absolutely integral to the development of the container ecosystem. Well, they've added a third standard for how we store, push, and pull images. Google announced Dataplane V2 for GKE and Anthos clusters. It's based on eBPF, and we'll dig into this one in the deep dive section. Sticking with eBPF, Microsoft announced a new OpenSoft project to make eBPF work on Windows 10 and modern versions of Windows servers. Now, it's early days for the project, but eBPF is making some massive waves in the industry, and Windows wants in on the action, which is a huge step away from the Microsoft of the 90s that really shunned standard networking protocols. So I say, good move, Microsoft, and to you as a viewer, keep an eye on eBPF. I've said on previous episodes that I love a good report. Well, this time it is Snyk's State of Cloud Native Application Security report. There's a bunch of interesting stuff in it, as you might expect, so we'll park that one for the deeper dive section as well. And last but not least for this month, Civo announced early availability of their Kubernetes platform based on the popular lightweight K3S. They're calling it production ready, and they're saying it's the world's first production ready platform built on K3S. So congrats to the Civo team. And that wraps up my news highlights for this month. Okay, so for the deeper dive this month, we're gonna look at Dataplane V2 for GKE and Anthos, and we'll look at some of the stats from Snyk's recently announced Cloud Native Application Security report. So Google announced this thing called Dataplane V2 for GKE and Anthos, and it's cool, don't get me wrong, but I wanna start out with its eBPF roots. In fact, it seems like everywhere you look at the moment, eBPF is making it large. I mean, we already mentioned that Microsoft are bringing it to Windows. Well, Dataplane V2 is for GKE and Anthos, and actually it's only for new GKE and Anthos clusters, but it gives you Kubernetes intelligence built into the network, so a network that is aware of Kubernetes. But you know what? What does that really mean? Well, in more concrete terms, you can tag network packets with Kubernetes metadata, and Dataplane V2, by way of eBPF, processes those packets in the kernel, so it's really fast, but it has the ability to read the Kubernetes metadata in the packets and make intelligent networking decisions on the fly. So it is a proper step in the direction of building and deploying Kubernetes on networks that understand Kubernetes. Now, as I mentioned, this implementation in Dataplane V2 is only for GKE and Anthos clusters. Plus as well, you also get automatic network policies and policy logging and loads more goodness. Oh, and you know what? It doesn't use kube proxy either, so it's really scalable, which is all good stuff if you're a Google customer. But this is the kind of thing we're gonna start seeing elsewhere more and more as Kubernetes becomes the industry standard and as things start bending to its will. Right, I love a good report as a snapshot of what is going on in the industry, and there's some really interesting stuff in this one. But I have to caveat it, right? It is based on around 600 customers that responded to the survey. So no doubt there's a ton of Snyk customers in there, and obviously it's people that are deploying cloud native apps. Either way though, 99% of customers that responded to the survey said that security was an important part of their cloud native strategy. Well, that's a no-brainer. I want to know, who are the 1% that don't think security is important? More seriously though, 68% of respondents viewed deployment velocity as a major reason behind their move to containers, whereas 67% cited ease of management and 43% cited reduced costs. But really interestingly, 36% cited improved security. Now this is interesting when you consider that containers are universally considered less secure than virtual machines. So what I think we're seeing here is the incredible set of tools and the likes that are built around containers and provide a better overall security posture. Like, for example, image vulnerability scanning. So you scan your images for known vulnerabilities and you get fancy reports. But you can also implement logic into your delivery pipelines to automate how these vulnerabilities are handled. So yes, while containers as a runtime might be less secure than VMs, thanks to the ecosystem and great tooling, the overall container experience can be more secure. Now, on the topic of containers, 78% of respondents are deploying workloads as containers, with 21% using serverless architectures. And while over 90% of respondents are using automation, only about a third have fully automated pipelines. One final thing I'll mention is the high number of security-related incidents being blamed on misconfiguration. Ouch. Well, there's more in the report, and I recommend you take a look yourself. You'll find the link below in the resources. That's it for this month's episode of Kubernetes This Month. If you like the show, be sure to give the episode a big thumbs up. Have a question? Add it into the comments. And if you've got any feedback, why don't you let us know what you think in our quick YouTube survey? We really want to bring you the best content we can, so let us know what you'd like to see. You can find the link in the survey below in the resources. Stay safe and don't forget to subscribe, because I'll be here again next month. Same Kube time, same Kube place.